The latest biologic brings a different approach to help to address the complexity of asthma pathophysiology, a top-down approach. TEZSPIRE, tezepelumab-ekko, is the first and only biologic to target and block thymic stromal lymphopoietin, or TSLP, a key epithelial cytokine that sits at the top of the inflammatory cascade and can drive multiple downstream inflammatory pathways and airway hyperresponsiveness. TEZSPIRE is indicated for the add-on maintenance treatment of adult and pediatric patients aged 12 years and older with severe asthma. TEZSPIRE is not indicated for the relief of acute bronchospasm or status asthmaticus. TEZSPIRE is the first and only biologic approved for severe asthma without phenotypic or biomarker limitations. Even in the current landscape, severe asthma is a complex disease to manage. It is heterogeneous and unpredictable, with varying triggers activating multiple pathways. It is characterized by two hallmarks: airway inflammation and airway hyperresponsiveness. Until recently, much of the focus has been on specific pathways or individual downstream inflammatory mediators. Looking at where pathologic inflammation often begins, at the airway epithelium, reveals a key target, TSLP. The airway epithelium is the first point of contact for viruses, allergens, pollutants, and other insults, which can cause the release of TSLP that can then drive downstream inflammatory pathways. TEZSPIRE is the first and only biologic to target and block TSLP, and in a mechanistic study, it has been shown to reduce airway inflammation and impact airway hyperresponsiveness. The clinical significance of this exploratory outcome on airway hyperresponsiveness, as well as the mechanism of action of TEZSPIRE, have not been established. Blocking TSLP reduces three key inflammatory biomarkers, as well as impacting tissue eosinophils and airway hyperresponsiveness. TEZSPIRE can help address the complexity of severe asthma and has a unique mechanism of action that targets TSLP at the top of the inflammatory cascade. Important safety information. Contraindications. Known hypersensitivity to tezepelumab-ekko or excipients. Warnings and precautions. Hypersensitivity reactions. Hypersensitivity reactions were observed in the clinical trials, example, rash and allergic conjunctivitis, following the administration of TEZSPIRE. Post-marketing cases of anaphylaxis have been reported. These reactions can occur within hours of administration, but in some instances have a delayed onset, i.e., days. In the event of a hypersensitivity reaction, consider the benefits and risks for the individual patient to determine whether to continue or discontinue treatment with TEZSPIRE. Acute asthma symptoms or deteriorating disease. TEZSPIRE should not be used to treat acute asthma symptoms, acute exacerbations, acute bronchospasm, or status asthmaticus. Abrupt reduction of corticosteroid dosage. Do not discontinue systemic or inhaled corticosteroids abruptly upon initiation of therapy with TEZSPIRE. Reductions in corticosteroid dose, if appropriate, should be gradual and performed under the direct supervision of a physician. Reduction in corticosteroid dose may be associated with systemic withdrawal symptoms and/or unmask conditions previously suppressed by systemic corticosteroid therapy. Parasitic helminth infection. It is unknown if TEZSPIRE will influence a patient's response against helminth infections. Treat patients with pre-existing helminth infections before initiating therapy with TEZSPIRE. If patients become infected while receiving TEZSPIRE and do not respond to anti-helminth treatment, discontinue TEZSPIRE until infection resolves. Live attenuated vaccines. The concomitant use of TEZSPIRE and live attenuated vaccines has not been evaluated. The use of live attenuated vaccines should be avoided in patients receiving TEZSPIRE. Adverse reactions. The most common adverse reactions, incidence greater than or equal to 3%, are pharyngitis, arthralgia, and back pain. Use in specific populations. There are no available data on TEZSPIRE use in pregnant women to evaluate for any drug-associated risk of major birth defects, miscarriage, or other adverse maternal or fetal outcomes. Placental transfer of monoclonal antibodies, such as tezepelumab-ekko, is greater during the third trimester of pregnancy. Therefore, potential effects on a fetus are likely to be greater during the third trimester of pregnancy. Indication. TEZSPIRE is indicated for the add-on maintenance treatment of adult and pediatric patients aged 12 years and older with severe asthma. TEZSPIRE is not indicated for the relief of acute bronchospasm or status asthmaticus. Please see full prescribing information, including patient information and instructions for use, available at tezspirehcp.com. You may report side effects related to AstraZeneca products by visiting https://us-aereporting.astrazeneca.com/adverse-events.html. The Spanish version of the adverse event reporting language is also available at this site. To learn more, visit tezspirehcp.com.